Erev Tov, good evening. We're studying tonight a continuation of Rabbi Yosef Kapach's introduction to the Rambam. We were discussing last night about the permissibility of ruling halachot like the Rambam. And there are those who wish to use the Rosh, the Teshuvah from the Rosh, a famous letter of his, that says that one cannot rule according to the Rambam unless he's an expert in Talmud and is able to rule from the Talmud, which essentially, the way Rav Kapach explains, is that somebody who's able to do that is already another Rambam, and therefore, for what purpose is the Rambam's Mishneh Torah for him? So we mentioned an opinion by passing of the first Lubavitch Rebbe, Rabbi Shneur Zalman of Liadi, who wrote a book called the Shulchan Aruch, known as the Shulchan Aruch Harav. Story has it, and how much of this is fact and how much of it is fiction, I highly recommend about the writings of the Lubavitch Rebbe to look up a book that I will attach if someone reminds me in the Google Classroom called The Quest for the Founder of Hasidut or something to that effect by Professor Rossman. In the last chapter, he has an entire essay on the writings of Chabad Lubavitch after the first Lubavitch Rebbe passes away, and how much of the works were actually in print, how many of them were not in print, the politics that surrounded the succession of the Lubavitch Rebbe later, who was going to take over, was it a son, was it a student, much which we knew and much that may come as a surprise to you. Nonetheless, the laws of Talmud Torah in the first Lubavitch Rebbe's Shulchan Aruch, I have a copy right here, there are many different editions of this, but the two most famous are those printed by Kehillat, by Chabad's printing press, as well as there's an edition printed by Oz v'Hadar in New Square. Rabbi Shneur Zalman of the Adi writes in the Laws of Talmud Torah, Katav, Morenu Harav Shneur Zalman Bichot Talmud Torah, Perek Bet, Kundres Acharon. That seems to be a Yemenite spelling of the word Kundres, which you'll see with a tet in other places. V'zeh Leshono, and this is his precise language. Vazil haRambam leShitato. We mentioned in passing that Rav Shneur Zalman of Liadi believed that it's not the correct interpretation of the Rosh's letter, but rather that the Rosh was saying that in cases where the Rambam does rule explicitly, you can rule like him. But in places where you're using your intellect and your knowledge of halakha to compare one case of the Rambam to a case in your reality, that doesn't count and you're not able to use the Rambam for that. And he brought a proof from Mishneh Torah of the Adi, which now we're going to analyze inside. Vazil haRambam leShitato. And the Rambam is simply following his own opinion. Shechiber sifro Mishneh Torah, that he wrote his book, the Mishneh Torah, beli netinat ta'amim lehalachot klal, without giving any reasons for the halachot. Meaning he doesn't give you the background. Hari, the whole purpose of the Rambam is to keep out all the complications and just to give you what you need. And he intended that people should use it to rule only from his book, without the need of other books. Like he writes in his Hagdama, Sham, that a person will not need any other book after the Tanakh, aside from the Mishneh Torah. Meaning, that is the intention of the Rambam. So if you want to say the Rambam didn't mean that, or that the Rosh means that you can't use the Rambam for that reason, we're going to discuss the Rosh in a moment. But definitely, according to the Rambam, he intended that people should use his book for Pesikat Halakha, for ruling Halakhot. And not like the Ma'adanei Melech. It's the same one that's called Ma'adanei Yom Tov on the Rosh. Rabbi Yom Tov Lipman Halevi Heller, the famous Rav Yom Tov Heller. So there's a number of books with the name Yom Tov or Ma'adanim inside of them, and those are the same author. And he writes Bagdama in his introduction, that which you say that it is only for those who are experts in the Talmud first, but in an actual letter of the Rosh, which Rabbi Yosef Kapach said last night, that people only study the second half of the letter, but not the letter's entirety. Lo katav ken, that's not what he writes. Ela leshoel seder halimud bekviut lemi shetorato omanuto, velo linyan hora klal ayin sham. If you look in the Rosh's letter, you'll see he's not even talking about ruling halachot. The question of can you rule halacha from the Rambam's Mishneh Torah is not the question, or at least the primary question, that the Rosh is dealing with. The question of the Rosh is, one who is a Tamid Chacham, who is learning Torah at a very high level, Torah umanuto, his Torah is all he does. How should he be studying? Should he be reading the Rambam's Mishneh Torah? Or should he be going back into the sources to discover the meanings of the halachot? Ayin sham, look there. V'hademorin halacha mitoch mishnatan hen mevalei olam. And that which the Gemara says in Masechet Sota, that those who rule according to the Mishnah, they are from the destroyers of the universe. By the way, the Chachamim tell us a number of things, people who are destroyers of the universe. One thing in this time of year that always comes to my mind is the famous teaching of the Chachamim, that a chassid shote, a righteous, a pious idiot, a pious fool, there's different ways to translate this, I don't want to get into exact English of this, a chassid who's also a shote. The Rambam explains, what is a chassid shote? The classic understanding of a chassid shote is somebody who sees a woman drowning in the river and doesn't save her. Why? I can't touch her. How can I save her? And he lets her die, chas v'shalom. This person is a mevale olam, he's a destroyer of the world. His righteousness causes him to be an idiot. The Rambam writes, what's the definition of a chassid shote? Shote bechassiduto. His righteousness. He is stupid in his righteousness. He is crazy in his righteousness. I'm not being medayek in my English, and it's not for now. The Rambam says, for example, inyenohu. What does it mean? Perush ha'gzama v'dikduk. The exaggeration and the particularness and details of halakha. Ad shenimas b'enei b'nei adam, says the Rambam, until he becomes repulsive in the eyes of humanity, of other people. You know those people? Every mitzvah, everything that they do is something that you did wrong. They become repulsive. Nobody wants to deal with these religious people. He says, the Rambam, this person is a mevalei olam. He's a destroyer of the world. How many things do we hear and see people do that it's chassidut of shotim? It's piety of foolish people. I didn't mean to go to this Rambam today, but I mean, that's what it wants. Okay. How often do we find people who in the cloak of Judaism destroy the world? I'll give you a good example for this. We discuss here around the Kollel table many times. The pitfalls of a person who is newly observant to Judaism, whether it's after many years or it's in the beginning of their life, or a person who's a ger tzedek, or a person who's any category of one who is rediscovering their Judaism. And we've mentioned the self-doubt that many in this world of, let's make people religious, and what do we ingrain them with? I'm not including myself in the category. They're ingrained with self-doubt, constant self-doubt, plagued with uncertainty. I'm a 40-year-old, 50-year-old, 30-year-old, 60-year-old professional. I have a career. I make money, Baruch Hashem. I have an education. I'm an intelligent, thinking human being. That's what brought me to Judaism in the first place. But now I met a rabbi, and the rabbi told me, you know, you think you know something? You don't even know how to tie your shoes in the morning. Right shoe, left shoe, left shoe, right shoe. Which direction do you put them on? How do you tie them? You don't know how to go to the bathroom, according to Halakha. If I don't know how to go to the bathroom, then I must not know anything. And the questions that people ask are terrifying. Why? Because we've taught them, again, a royal we, to self-doubt everything they know. This creates crazy people. I'm not picking only on those who are returning to Judaism. The Jewish community, Baruch Hashem, gives birth to thousands of people like this every day. But by them, I have no expectation. They were raised to be crazy. But the people who were raised to be normal, in their normalcy, found Judaism. I cry about them. They could have brought to Judaism sanity and balance. And instead, they were thrown off balance and led to insanity by the Jewish establishment itself. So one who rules according to the Mishnah is from the destroyer of the world. Svira lele Rambam kidach te'ama. So listen, you can't rule according to the Mishnah. How can you rule according to the Rambam? The Rambam is going according to the logic b'pirush Rashi sham, according to Rashi's commentary. Now whether he's really learning Rashi or not, that's not what he's trying to say. Rather, in this idea, diyesh mishnayot harbe dichidahi veletilchata. There are many mishnayot that are individual opinions of Chachamim. Not everything in the Mishnah is a halakha. Last year, Pesach time, someone said to me, you know what the Mishnah says? Every Mishnah is a halakha. If Rambam doesn't rule it in halakha, if Maran doesn't codify it in halakha, now it became a halakha because the Mishnah said it. The Mishnah has a lot of opinions. A person doesn't know the sift between what is hilchata and what is not hilchata. What is law and what is not? The second, This whole teaching is talking about Mishnayot, not talking about the Rambam. So don't bring a proof from there against ruling the Rambam. Ma she'en ken chiburo, this is different than the Rambam's chibur, his writing. Shechiburo mitoch maskanat Talmud. The Rambam is not a Mishnah. The Rambam is not in the beginning of the evolution of Halakha. The Rambam is telling you what was sealed into law, what was codified as national Jewish law in the Talmud. And that which the Rosh, which was quoted by Maran, the case of Mishneh yesterday, that's what we are talking about, a situation, and this is what the Rosh is referring to, a situation in which the person does not have a clear precedent in the Rambam. Did the Rambam say? The Rambam doesn't speak about this. Did the Rambam tell you what you could do on Shabbat? No, in this matter, it's a new matter. Or it wasn't revealed in the Rambam. So now I'm coming along and saying, well, it's similar enough to something the Rambam said in Hilchot Shabbat, something the Rambam wrote in Hilchot this. And now I decided to extrapolate from here and apply it to this. Copy and paste is a dangerous art. Maybe you're copying and pasting two things that seem identical, but if you would have a little more background in Talmud, you would realize they're not the same beast at all. That's what the Rosh is referring to. I'm skipping the brackets. It's what I explained outside. Let's read the brackets quickly. אבל כאשר הדבר מפורש מהרמב״ם, מודה הרוש יש לפסוק מהרמב״ם גם בלי שום ידיעה אחרת. In a place where the Rambam ruled exclusively, of course, the Rosh means you could rule like that. Ki lakach nozar, it's for that reason that the book of the Rambam was created. Huva b'Rabbenu Yerucham. Rabbenu Yerucham, who I mentioned to you before, and it's a chacham that is worth looking into. And I mentioned in the Google Classroom the fear that people have of printing his books again, which is why his books are really missing in many Batei Midrash. The Rabbenu Yerucham writes, Kol ma'aseh sheba eino bagmara, any situation which is not mentioned in the Talmud, רצה לומר שזה המעשה שבא לפני המורה, לא בא הוא בעצמו ממש מחכמי הגמרא, that the exact case you're dealing with in its exact similarity is not mentioned in the Talmud. In that situation, you're now dealing with a new situation. אזיל לטעמי שחיבר חיבורו כהרמב״ם בלי טעמים כלל, ועשו גם כן להורות מתוכו לבדו, לכל מי שרוצה לסמוך על הדין הכתוב בספר, that in situations where things are similar, I'm skipping here little pieces, where things are similar, you can't use your own judgment just from a book. But in a place where they're identical, of course you can follow. That's the reason for the book. ולדברי מוהרינו הרב שניר זלמן הללו, and to these words of רב שניר זלמן, רמז גם הרב נהורה דאורייתא, רב יהושע פלק, עליו השלום, in his book, נהורה דאורייתא, also alludes to it, מאמר שני פרק ד' זיין, in the second essay. וכדי שיובנו דברי מורינו הרב שניר זלמן זצל, and in order that you will understand in context the words of רב שניר זלמן of Liadi, אביא כאן חציה הראשון של תשובת הראש, ומעשה שהיה, שלב מדובר בתשובה. I'll bring the other half of the Rosh, which is not usually quoted, in order to explain. If you turn with me to page Qaf, we're at the top right. כתב הראש כלל למד א' סימן ת'. The Rosh writes in rule 31, in chapter 9, and to tell you the truth is, in order to understand this Rosh properly, you and I are going to have to sit down and go through all of Hilchot Mikvaot, which we don't have time to do right now. So I'm actually going to be from those who skip most of the Rosh and read to you his conclusion. But let's start at the beginning. Ma shekatav Rabbeinu Matzliach, that which Rabbeinu Matzliach writes, Ma'aseh she'ira sham, there was a story that happened there. Shehishlichu mayim she'uvin betoch mayan ha'mayim, they put mayim she'uvin into a mayan of water. So they put, and he ruled against this situation where they put this water into that water. Okay, and he quotes here a passage, and he also quotes the Rambam, not just the Talmud. And I'm skipping a few lines. ולא יפה כיוון, says the Rosh. It's not correct that he compared this case to that case. דמותרו, it's permissible. And he mentions why it's permissible, and it's explicitly in the Talmud. כל שכן בידון זה, שמושכין המים למקום אחר. Okay, that's also משיכה. ומה שהביא מדברי הרמב״ם, לא הבין דבריו. And that which he quotes the Rambam, He didn't understand what the Rambam said. Ki hu katav mitoch ha-tosefta. He's ruling like a tosefta. The Tanya, the Tosef says, ve'elu hen mei tamtzit kol zman she'akshrim yordin ve'harim botzetzin. Different versions of the tosefta here. Again, this is a case that has many intricacies. Zo ha-braita katav ha-Rambam zan. This braita, the Rambam wrote it. ולא עירי לעניין מקווה, אלא לעניין החילוק שיש בין מי גבאים ובין מי התמצית. The Rambam is making a differentiation here, not about מקוואות, not about מקוואות, but different kinds of waters. כתנן ברקם את המקוואות, like it says in the first chapter, מקוואות, שש מעלות מקוואות. וכן כל המורים הוראות מתוך דברי הרמב״ם, ואינן בקיאים בתלמוד לידע מאיכן הוציא דבריו, טועין להתיר האסור ולסור את המותר,
And that's where the Rosh concludes that if you don't know the origin of the Rambam that you're talking about, then you may come to think it's talking about mikvot. It's talking about water, yes. Mikvot, no. And what ultimately happens is you incorrectly compare two incomparable cases, and now you come out with the conclusion in the laws of mikvot that have nothing to do with mikvot.
Ata horita ladat. I've now shown you. כי שפתי מורנו הרב שניאור זלמן ברור מלאנו. That the lips of Rabbi Shlomo Zalman spoke truth. והערכתי בבורה, and I elaborated on this point, כי חצי תשובה זו שימשה בידי נשק לתקוף שלא לפסוק מספרו של הרמב״ם. He said, because I've used this other half of the letter as a weapon to fight against those who tell me you cannot rule like the Rambam.
ואף בזאת רבנו ירוחם חולק, and even in the situation where it's incomparable, רבנו ירוחם argues, וסובר אני הולד, דאף יכול המורה שאינו בקי במוצא הדין, that even one who's ruling on halakha, and he's not an expert in that passage of the Talmud, לדמות מקרהו לדין המפורש ברמב״ם לפסוק. He disagrees with this entirely, the Rabbeinu Yerucham. Rabbeinu Yerucham says that if you are asking a halakha question, or answering a halakha question, and you're not familiar with the Talmud in this piece, you only know the Rambam in this piece, and you're going to compare a case that's in reality in front of you, which is not exactly the same as the Rambam's case, but you want to compare them and therefore rule a law that way.
ואף שיתכן שיתאה בדמיונו, דימויו, even though a person will possibly make a mistake in his comparison because they're incomparable,
מוטב שיתאה אחד ממאה, it's proper that you should make a mistake 1 out of 100 times. ואל יטעו 99 מתוך עיונם בתלמוד. And you shouldn't be like those who make 99 errors out of 100 because they only learn halakha from the Talmud. וחושבים שהם בקיאים בו. And they think that they're experts in it. ומי לא חושב שהוא בקיא בו? Who doesn't think he's an expert in Talmud? Everybody, I'm an expert in this, I'm an expert in that. Everybody becomes an expert. So Rabbeinu Yerucham says, I'd rather you rule like the Rambam and 99% of the time be correct than think that you're too good to rule like the Rambam and 99% of the time be incorrect.
וכן דעת עטרת ראשנו מורנו הרב חיים בן עטר זל. And this is the opinion of Rabbeinu Chaim Ben Attar. Again, these are unusual sources, perhaps, for Rav Kapach to be quoting. Rav Chaim Ben Attar is the rabbi of the Chida. He's from North Africa. He wrote the famous Or Chaim HaKadosh. Not Or HaChaim that you have in Shulchan Aruch, Or HaChaim that you have in the Torah. He was a famous Kabbalist in North Africa, later made it to Israel, lived in the old city of Yerushalayim. Famous meetings were supposed to happen between him and the Abu Lafia family. If you listen to my Shiurim on Yom HaAtzmaut, you'll come to some of that history over there. He has a number of books that recently I was zoche to get my hands on a whole set of the writings of Rabbeinu Chaim Ben Attar. What I mean recently? In the last 2 years. So I have in front of me a book, the writings of Or Chaim HaKadosh on the Shas, and you want to go to Rishon Lezion and look into his writings on Masechet Berachot and on Masechet Sukkah. And the quotes that we're about to quote here are from those two volumes of Rav Chaim Ben Attar's book, Rishon Lezion.
Katav HaRishon Lezion b'chidushav leberachot daf samech. The Rishon Lezion, Rav Chaim Ben Attar writes in his commentaries and his novel insight into the Masechet Berachot, אבל בדברי הרמב״ם דלא יתקר אלא הלכה פסוקה מנסת על כדעתך לחלק. The things that are written in the Rambam that are explicitly halakha, where did you think of arguing with them? Or to make the differences between them? וכבר כתבתי בכמה מקומות, and I already wrote in a number of places, דה הרמב״ם בפסקיו שמח שיפסוק הפוסק מספרו בין צורך לראות השס. I already told you many times in my books, says Rav Chaim Ben Attar, that the Rambam intended that you should use his books to rule in all areas of halakha without needing to look in the Talmud at all. Ki mimeno totzaot Torah ta'adam, all of the conclusions of man's life, it's, everything is there. וחפיזה לא יחוש לטעויות הנמשכות מדברי השז, and do me a favor, says Rabbeinu Chaim Ben Attar, don't be concerned with mistakes that might come from you not knowing the shas. ושמור לך כלל זה, and remember this matter always. This rule is a rule. The Rambam was meant to rule halakha like him. And even if you don't know the Talmud, know the Rambam. Ayin sham, see there. וחידושיו לסוכה דף י"ב כתב, and in his commentary on מסכת סוכה, on page 12, he writes, ומשום דה הרמב״ם לא סמך על הלומד בספרו, שיבין העניין, אלא למה שכתב בספרו. The Rambam intends that you should only know halakha from his book. He doesn't intend that you should have any other background. And therefore, don't be scared to rule halakhot like the Rambam. I wanted to take just a few minutes and elaborate here on a point that's not brought down in Rav Kapach's work, at least not in this point. It's a tshuva that is very dear to Mori Harav Yaakov Peretz. Should even be well. It's found in the writings of the Ri Migash, or Ri Ibn Migash. I posted a link in the Google Classroom, so if you want to go to the Rambam, or if you're in the regular classroom, just look for it. It's not the one that has his biography, it's another link that has a link to Sefaria, to his Teshuva. Siman Kuf Yud Dalid, 140. Shela, the Ri Migash has asked a question. Question. Ma yomar adonenu, what would our master say? Be'ish, about a man shelo kara me'olam halakha im rav, who never learned halakha from a rabbi, ve'no yodea derech halakha, he doesn't know the way of halakha, ve'lo perusha, ve'lo kiriyata, he doesn't know how to explain it, and doesn't know how to read it, doesn't know anything. Ela shehu ra'a harbe mitshuvot ha'gaonim zal v'sifrei dayanim. But he's an expert in the writings of all the gaonim and you know, teachings of the dayanim. Imagine like today someone saying, I don't know Talmud, I don't know Rambam, I don't even know Shulchan Aruch. I know the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, backwards and forth. No insults to the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. Just, it's a very short book that everybody could become an expert in. ולא נעלם מאדוננו שהתשובות אינם עומדות על מצב אחד ועד הישנות. Okay. And you know there are many mistakes that happen in the writings of the Geonim, that sometimes the Geonim ruled something and then took it back. ועם איש שעיקר ידיעתו בתשובות אלו. Therefore, if a man who most of his Torah knowledge comes from these writings, ואינו מבין הצדק מהם מבלתי הצדק, and he doesn't know to tell them apart what's right or what's not, אם יוכל להורות בעניין אחד או בנידון אחד ויפסוק הדין בו, can he rule according to one of these matters from the knowledge he has without the Talmud, only in the knowledge of the writings of the rabbis? ואפשר להיות שאותה שהורה ממנה כבר חזר בו המורה, and it could be that even the ruling that he's following, already the rabbi who wrote it took it back. ומי שאינו מבין עיקר הדין ולא מאיזה מקום יצא מן התלמוד, אם הוא מותר להורות או אין ראוי לסמוך עליו בשום דבר. If a person doesn't know the origin of every halakha in the Talmud, only knows them from the books of the halakhot. Let's say today, he knows Shulchan Aruch, but he doesn't know the Talmud, he doesn't know the Bet Yosef. Can he rule halakha like that? בפרט אם הוא בלתי ירא שמיים. Now he's going to talk about if he's not ירא שמיים at all. That's a fascinating part of the letter that I don't want to get into tonight. תשובה, answer, says Rabbi Migash. Da, you should know, שהאיש הזה, that this man, ראוי יותר להתיר לו להורות, it's more fitting to let him rule halakha, מאנשים רבים קבעו עצמם להוראה בזמננו זה, from the other people who are currently ruling halakha today. Meaning, it would be better to let this man rule halakha than the people that you and I know are ruling halakha today. You think there are new problems in the 20th century, 21st century. You look at history, wow, these problems started 200 years ago, 300 years ago. These are old problems. The problems you and I face today are problems that existed in the Jewish community always. ורובם, and most of them, אין להם אפילו אחד משני הדברים האלו. These people don't even have any of those two things. רצוני לומר, הבנת הלכה והמידע על דת הגאונים. They don't understand הלכה, and they don't know the writings of the גאונים. How many times do I hear פסקי הלכות running around here? This rabbi said this, this rabbi told me that, about a mikveh, about a kashrut, about... I say, ריבון העולמים, where did the rabbi learn? Oh, he didn't learn. I had a rabbi once call me up, challenging a giyu. Not that I did. I didn't do the giyu. How do you hold of that giyu? Why not? In hilchot giyu of Shulchan Aruch, of the Rama. He said, I don't even own a hilchot giyu of the Shulchan Aruch. I looked at him and I said, don't own me. You don't have a Shulchan Aruch. I don't have it. He said, did you ever read it? I never learned hilchot giyu. I said, so why do you have an opinion about hilchot giyu? Who gave you the right to have an opinion? Says Ri Migash, if only the rabbis had some knowledge. They don't even have that knowledge of this man that you're telling me doesn't know Talmud, but he knows Halacha. ואותם שמדמים להוראות מיון ההלכה ומחוזק עיונם בתלמוד, הם שראוי למונע מזה. And those who claim that they skip all of those cheap, easy books, and they only rule according to the Talmud. I knew many people like that when I was in yeshiva, not in Israel. Is that those are the people you should keep away from ruling halachot. לפי שאין בזמננו זה מי שיהיה ראוי לכך. There's nobody in our generation who knows how to rule halacha properly just from the Talmud. ולא מי שהגיע בחוכמת התלמוד לכלל שיעורי מיונו מבלי שעמוד הדעת הגאונים זל. There's no one who can properly rule a Talmud without getting help from the גאונים. And listen to this, this is fascinating, and this is a backup again like Rabbi Yerucham. אבל מי שמורה מתשובות הגאונים, but somebody who rules like the rulings of the גאונים, וסומך עליהם, and he relies on them, ואף על פי שאינו יכול להבין בתלמוד, even though he doesn't know how to understand anything in the Talmud, הוא יותר הגון ומשובח מאותו שחושב שהוא יודע בתלמוד וסומך על עצמו. He is more fitting and more praiseworthy than the one who thinks he knows and doesn't know anything. At least this one knows the writings of the גאונים. שהוא אף על פי שהוא מורה בלתי אמיתות מסברות הגאונים, even though he doesn't know how to properly learn the writings of the גאונים, מכל מקום אינו טועה בזה, he doesn't make mistakes in the things that they said, לפי שהוא מה שעשה על פי בדין גדול מומחה לרבים עשה. He is ruling the halacha according to an expert בדין of the masses. ומי שמורה מעיונו בהלכה, and to the contrary, the one who says, I teach halacha because I'm an expert and I went back to the sources. אפשר שהוא חושב שאותה הלכה מחייבת ההוראה, he thinks that that's what the halacha is, והיא אינה מחייבת, ויתאו עיונו אותה בפירושה, and he made a mistake or he didn't understand things properly, ואין בזמננו זה מי שיגיע בתלמוד לגדר שיוכל לסמוך לראות ממנו. There's nobody in our generation who's reached this level where he knows how to rule halacha on his own without the help of the rabbis after the Talmud. In my notes here, it quotes an Or Zaroa. The Or Zaroa is quoted also in the Darchei Moshe. Who's Darchei Moshe? Anyone there? That's the Rama. The Rama says, "Achshav biyamenu nowadays, shebaavonot harabim, that do our great sins, nitma'ata haTorah v'chasra haChokma, that wisdom has been diminished from the world. Meshabeach ani itatzlanim. I praise the lazy rabbis. Shelo yismechu al chokmatam v'niru la'akel." That the rabbis shouldn't rely on their own judgment to go look in Talmudic sources to be lenient. V'kablu sachar al ha-perisha yoter min ha-derisha. And they'll receive a reward for what they don't say more than those who have what to say. One day, if you want, I can give you a shiur on this topic. What's better? This obviously didn't go over well with many rabbis. This tshuva of the Ri Migash, many people struggle with it. Later generations also struggle with it. Even current generations struggle with it. I know that when I sat with Mori Arav, Yaakov Peretz, should live and be well, this is a tshuva that he always kept close to him. What's going to happen to you if you rule like the Shulchan Aruch? What'll be with you? You think after 120 years, I follow the Rambam, they're going to put you in Gehenom. What's going to happen? What happens when you go after 120 years? I dismissed the Rambam. I dismissed the Shulchan Aruch. Who cares about them? I relied on X, Y, and Z. But what if you're wrong? When you follow the Rambam, you follow Maran, you're following a Beit Din HaGadol. Okay, maybe not comparable to the Geonim, but close. You are following the rabbis that the whole generation followed. It would be better for you to err on that side of caution and to be full of ego and arrogance and to think that you know. Oftentimes, those who say, I can't follow the Rambam, I don't follow. Those people, it's just a cover-up for their ego, their arrogance, their pride that doesn't let them to submit to an authority in Halakha that is greater than them. So Hashem, we'll continue this next week.